Okay, I'm going to do a little experiment here to see if a Sony microphone jack with plug-in power can accept the line level source. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because Kodak is going to be coming out with a new pocket camcorder in September, the ZI-8, which has a stereo external microphone jack. And from the videos they have on Kodak's channel, it appears to be the same type as a Sony, that it powers the microphone with voltage coming out of the microphone jack. And I was just wondering if that would be compatible with a line level source for recording music. Now I have my little Sony MiniDisc recorder here. This is an old model. It's says January 2000 on it. But it does have that same type of a microphone jack on it. And I'll just do a little experiment here. I have this little GE PC microphone. This is a very good microphone if you can find it. They sell it at Target for about 10 bucks. And it's very sensitive, very good for computers and things like that. So I'll just give a little demo using this microphone. Let's turn this thing on. Alright, go to the end of the disc. Once it spins up, come on. Takes a while. There we go. Okay, let's do recording pause. Now I'll switch you over. Okay, this is the G. That's actually too loud. This is too sensitive. There we go. A little better. This is the GE microphone doing a direct feed through the output of the Sony MiniDisc recorder. So that proves that microphone is working. All right, now I'll plug in my line level cable here and I'll measure the voltage on this thing. See what kind of voltage Sony is putting out. My voltmeter here. Okay, that's the ground. Okay, there's about 2.46 volts on the left channel and 2.45 volts on the right channel. Now the question is, will that harm a line level output? Now my victim here will be my little iPod. I'll just plug it right in. And now there's 2.45 volts going right into the iPod. I'll turn it on. I'll switch over to the Sony's output. Okay, now we're going to try to see if it'll play. Okay, it doesn't seem to be hurting the iPod. I can't guarantee this about other devices, but at least the iPod seems to be working. Let's see what songs I can get on here. You're like a storm against the wind. There's a nice one, ABBA. The drums on this song are so strong, you can hear the auto level control of the MiniDisc recorder reacting to it. Let's go back to the little GE microphone. Make sure that still works. Okay, this is the GE microphone. Alright, so at least it works with an iPod. So that's a good sign that the little Kodak ZI-8 may be useful for recording music through its microphone input. if it follows the same standards as the Sony, because on Kodak's channel they actually demonstrate it using a Sony external microphone. You can see it in their latest video, and so if that works, then it should work equally as well as an official Sony input. So there we go. 2.45 volts will not kill an iPod. I can't guarantee anything else. I was going to use this little $10 cheapo MP3 player I got at Target, but they use one of those sub-mini jacks, you know, smaller than a regular headphone jack. I do have the adapter somewhere, but I can't find it. So, oh well. So there you go. Hope you find this useful if you're considering the Kodak ZI-8, or just wondering if a Sony camcorder will let you plug a line level source into its microphone input.